Hi.
Hi there. How are you doing?
Really good.
Is coffee going moving?
I'm good.
Oh, sorry, I got your foot.
Oh, I'm sorry. We're getting real friendly. Get your cool hair.
It's TARDIS blue. I'm a Doctor Who fan.
Perfect.
Love it.
We're good.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, the only thing we can see is when we walk around, is between interviews and what have you, but we haven't seen the floor and probably won't.
I met all the Disney princesses, which I was very excited about, including Moana and the Little Mermaid, of course. And I also had the pleasure of getting proposed to by, like...
I saw that on Twitter.
By like 9 million Outlander men without their shirts on. So that was a new experience.
It's a story. So now when they say what's your weirdest fan encounter, you go, I don't even know if you're fans, but it happened.
I got thrown into the fire and I went with it.
So can you talk about your characters in the show and the relationships that they have?
Go ahead. Ladies first.
Always. I play Olivia Charity. She is an assassin. She has an incredibly painful childhood, as we'll learn as the series goes on. And it explains part of why she doesn't trust men, why she's so angry. She's found a lot of compassion and friendship and also in like therapeutic healing in her relationship with Len. And the two of them together are very protective of the Midnighter. Well, protective of the town of Midnight and the other Midnighters.
And I play Lemuel Bridger, who is the resident town vampire. Been around a couple hundred years and has over the years been given the gift and adaptation of the ability to leech energy for his survival. So he doesn't actually need to feed on blood to survive, and that allows him to live in Midnight and to develop a relationship with someone living.
It's a very sexy relationship. Human supernatural.
It's definitely different. I don't think anybody's seen anything quite like this.
He's a very special vampire because he leeches. So instead of sucking blood to survive, he's able to suck energy.
Right.
Tell them more about it.
Right. So in I think as you watch the episodes, at some point each of us, our backgrounds get explored a little bit more, and you get to learn how we became the way we are. And with Lem actually at a certain stage was a regular vampire, and something happened. And so in subsequent episodes you will see what happened that made his eyes blue, that turned him into the way he is. And so what he does is he can actually leech energy from living creatures and people. And depending on the severity of the leeching, it can be something devastating, could actually kill, or it could actually be essential experience, which is
healing.
What he has developed with Olivia. Yes. This is Lem is an unusual, like he is a very different vampire. I think there's less of there are times his fangs will show, but he doesn't show them all the time. And
there's some brutal moments. Oh, episode 6. Just hang on, guys. Hang on.
Yeah, I think he has sort of a lot of the typical vampire characteristics: speed, strength, longevity. So I think he's recognizable as a vampire, but you're going to meet a very different kind of supernatural. And I think that's what you'll find in Midnight. The humans and the supernaturals are all a little bit different. Their stories aren't as obvious as you might think.
Given that you've played a vampire, can you give me any tips?
No, he's got this.
You got it down.
Yeah.
And actually, this is my second stint as a vampire.
Yeah.
So you're from the land of Hammer Films. Did you like base your character off of any traits that you from previous works from over there?
No. Well, yeah, not really. This is really an adaptation of the character that Charlene Harris pieced together. So it was just more important for us to actually be true to the characters developed. And
Monica, I feel our show creator, yeah. Monica Brain, I feel like she did an amazing job of understanding the heart and the essence of each character,
right,
and casting that. So the characters may not look like the characters in the book, but the essence is there. And I think that's also what made it so exciting for each of us to work with the cast, is like to see them come off the page and come to life.